The story of our communities, people and nation starts a long, long time ago. More than 60,000 years, in fact. This was when our culture and our law first started to thrive. We knew who we were and where we belonged. We took care of each other, our land and our waters. We ate food that made us healthy, lived on country and abided by our laws and song lines. Our families, our children were happy with strong minds and hearts because they were where they belonged. But then everything changed.
Colonization came, bringing wars, disease, famine, violence, and the destruction and violation of our cultural laws, sacred sites, families, and communities.
We were denied our knowledge, language, ceremonies, and identity, the very things that tell us who we are and where we belong, and our connections with each other and the land grew weak.
And then, our children were taken from us. They had their names changed and their identities stripped away. They were told that Aboriginal people were bad. Worse still, they were told that their parents and grandparents did not want them.
For years this happened, and those children became known as the Stolen Generations.
Our children were denied love and experienced physical, emotional, and sexual abuse. This left very deep, very complex, and very real wounds, leaving scars that are still being felt personally, socially, spiritually, and collectively.
In the time when our story started, we were able to parent in the cultural way that has seen our families survive and thrive for generations. Our people were strong, and our culture flowed and healed us in times of hurt.
But since the trauma of colonization and the Stolen Generations, we have not been able to heal in the same way. And we have unknowingly passed this trauma on to our children through sharing our sad stories and having them witness and experience our pain. This is known as intergenerational trauma, and we see symptoms today in broken relationships, disconnected families, violence, suicide, and drug and alcohol abuse.
But this is not where our story ends. We still have strong minds and hearts, and we still know who we were and where we belong. By creating safe and strong communities together, supporting our families to be free from pain, returning to our culture and building a strength of identity, we can stop the cycle of trauma and bring about positive intergenerational change, so that we can continue to thrive for the next 60,000 years. There are simple things that we can all do to help heal our trauma.
Visit healingfoundation.org.au to find out more.